Good afternoon. My name is Brian O'Hara, BRIANOHARA, Minneapolis Police Chief. So I'm sure, as many of you know, last week we had two incidents where two of our masjids in South Minneapolis were set on fire while people were inside praying. That included women, children, and families. And obviously, an act so heinous is clearly one that's intended to inflict terror into the hearts of our community members. Houses of worship are sacred spaces in our city, and many of them, including our masjids, serve as resources for our community, for families to gather, for daycare, for children's activities. So setting fire to a sacred facility where children and family gather is incredibly inhumane. This level of blatant hatred cannot be tolerated. On Monday, I was visiting Masjid Omar with Imam, with Jelani Hussein from CARE, and members of the community there to discuss the fire that had just happened before. By the time I left there and met with the U.S. attorney to discuss what was going on in this case, I got a phone call again from Jelani indicating that we had another masjid on fire in the city. So I responded down there that night, was on the phone with the U.S. attorney, with the FBI, ATF, and all of those federal resources came to the scene that night. And I can tell you that night, it wasn't even clear to us if the two incidents were connected or if it even was another act of arson. But I'm just incredibly thankful for the hard work of literally dozens of members of the Minneapolis police, for the involvement of the U.S. Attorney's Office, the FBI, and the ATF, and their tireless work to bring this individual to justice. This type of hatred will not ever stand in Minneapolis. Let this be a lesson to anyone who seeks to inflict hate upon our residents, that we will not tolerate that. We will remove you from our streets, and we will ensure that you are brought to justice. I got off the phone earlier today before I came here with the sheriff of Blue Earth County, Blue Earth County Sheriff's Office. And last night, just as a matter of routine, the sheriff's office there has a contract to do certain transports between medical facilities and mental health facilities. And when a call came in to do a transport last night, the attentiveness of a dispatcher realized that this was the person that we were interested in making an arrest. So thanks to the work of the dispatcher, the chief deputy from Blue Earth County, the sheriff of Blue Earth County, that person was safely arrested last night. It had been a long week with dozens of officers involved in this investigation, dozens of Minneapolis officers, members of the FBI, ATF, St. Paul Police had been helping us, the Hennepin County Attorney's Office. So we are incredibly thankful now that community can have some sense of relief that this person is off the street. And with this arrest, I can confirm that through our investigation, we are not aware of any other known threat to any masjid or any other houses of worship in our city. Mayor?
Chief, thank you. My purpose in being here today on a Sunday afternoon is to say thank you. Chief, excellent work. Thank you to you and your Minneapolis police officers. Thank you to our firefighters that responded very quickly. Thank you to the U.S. Attorney's Office. This indeed has been a federal investigation, and we're so proud to partner and work with them. And thank you to all of our local law enforcement and prosecutorial entities that have helped out to make this possible. The message that the chief said has to be heard loud and clear. If you're going to inflict hate or terror on our communities, we are going to hold you accountable. We told the world, we told people, residents of our city, earlier that if this kind of thing happens, you will be held accountable, and that's exactly what's taking place here. So again, thank you to all of our partners in making this a reality here. We want to make sure that if you visit a place of worship that are meant to be places of peace and are meant to be sacred, that you are not afraid to do so at the same time. This is a great step in the direction towards peace and religious freedom.
Thank you, Mayor. And the mayor was with me visiting some of these mass students and members of our community throughout the week, as well as members of the municipal council here. So thank you, Mayor, for your leadership and for helping me engage with so many members of the community, because I know that that meant so much to them. As the mayor mentioned, as I have mentioned, this is a federal investigation. It's my understanding that the U.S. attorney has released a statement and a complaint in regard to this matter. And I can tell you, you know, having been on the phone with the U.S. attorney several times a day for the last week, that there will be more to come, that you can expect to have more information released during the course of this week, and we will know more information potentially of additional charges. Any questions?
At this point, do you know of a motive, or is that part of the federal investigation?
That's part of the overall investigation, but like I've said from the beginning, clearly there is a pattern behind this, and you know, it's one thing to say a prosecutor needs to establish a certain level of proof to prove criminal charges, but as far as I'm concerned, you know, we are going to assume that this is motivated by hate, this is motivated by bias, and that's why we've been reaching out to all of law enforcement who would possibly listen to us to raise the alarm on this and ensure that we're getting a very swift response to bring this person to justice. Yeah, I can't explain that. I can tell you we have been very close on this person's tail over the last week. He's moved around several times. You know, a lot of that will come out, you know, as more information is released. But yeah, the most I can tell you is that the Blue Earth County Sheriff's Office does have a contract to provide transportation between certain medical facilities for mental health issues and others, and really it's only due to the attentiveness of the dispatcher and the officers involved, and then the chief deputy who responded himself to make sure that this person was arrested and taken into custody. So it's a great story about how law enforcement works. This is all week. We've had dozens of folks involved from, again, U.S. Attorney's Office, Hennepin County, FBI, ATF, the County Sheriff's Office, and kind of everybody coming together and doing their due diligence, being attentive, and that's how this person got off the street. And that's I'm incredibly thankful for that, because, you know, nobody's looking to take credit for it. They were just looking to ensure that our people can be safe. So I'm incredibly thankful for that. Yes, sir.
When you're down significant numbers of officers, having these partnerships are all the more crucial. And one of the things that you've seen over the last several months is these extraordinary expanded partnerships between local, state, and federal entities. And I'll tell you, they've helped a whole lot, making sure that we are as strategically as possible deploying the resources that we have and working together with other jurisdictions. That's ultimately what led to the result that we're here on today. And that's part of the progress going forward.
I know that, Chief, there was added security when this person was still out there.
Yeah.
Is that changing at all, even though there's been an arrest?
As I mentioned, we have no known information to indicate that there is any longer a threat. However, we recognize that people's perception at times, you know, can be damaged. This person clearly, you know, walking right into a house of worship that is open to community, walking right past people who are praying and lighting a fire while people are inside is absolutely outrageous. And, you know, even though we have this person into custody, we will ensure that we do continue to have enhanced patrols around all houses of worship. You know, we don't know. Maybe this person, if they remained on the street, would decided that their next target would be a Catholic church or a synagogue. We don't know, or some other place where community gather. So we want to make sure that we're doing, you know, everything possible to have some enhanced presence so that people can return to some sense of a better sense of safety. And you know, we have instituted some changes internally here to ensure that this type of thing is elevated and raised from the moment a 911 call comes in. So, for example, I've worked with the 911 Communications Center to ensure that anytime someone calls 911 for an emergency or potentially a crime in any house of worship, that as soon as the call is received, the field supervisor from police is immediately notified over the radio. Because we want to ensure that is something that is, you know, very well aware, because oftentimes the field supervisor, the police officers in the field can have information that our dispatchers don't. And we want to make sure that, you know, in an instance here where we've had instances at houses of worship, that we ensure that we're responding as swiftly and as thoroughly as possible. We believe he is responsible for both masjids. We also believe he is responsible for other acts of vandalism that have occurred that are somewhat related over the last several months. And I believe, just in conversations with folks from community, that other acts have happened, that other acts of vandalism and things like that, which he may have been responsible for, but ultimately were not reported to police. Because people thought those things were minor, they didn't think anything of it. But now, you know, in conversations with community, being present, you know, we have learned that there's potentially other things that have happened, you know, outside of arson, that this person may be responsible for that weren't even reported.
Are those incidents the same community or just different
communities? I'm not sure if it is exclusively Muslim or exclusively to Somali community, but that is definitely a pattern in there. However, it could be others. You know, I think our malls had been targeted. So yeah, I mean, there is a correlation there, but I don't know if it's specific only to that.
I know that you guys just recently passed the ordinance for a call to prayer. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Any correlations?
Well, it's certainly a concern. It is a fact, you know, that the mayor and the council did make that change, and it is a fact that these incidents occurred after. There's other incidents that occurred prior, acts of vandalism, but, you know, arson in a house of worship is a significant escalation from someone who is spraying graffiti or causing other damage. So, yeah, I mean, it is simply a fact that is the order that these things happen. Yes.
Do you know if this guy, I saw in the complaint that he had threatened Representative Omar? Are you guys aware of that?
Yes, we are aware of that, and have been in contact with the representative's office. Yeah, there had been a report several months ago of some graffiti that we believe is connected to other acts of graffiti in Minneapolis, and we believe the same individual is responsible for. Yes.
Just knowing all of that stuff, the many acts of arson, the graffiti, the threat he's had in this community, just knowing he's behind bars now, just how are you feeling?
I am incredibly relieved. You know, we cannot physically be everywhere. We had, as I mentioned, you know, we had our own officers, dozens of our own officers working on this around the clock. We had the U.S. attorney personally involved and designating an assistant U.S. attorney to be with us 24/7, the Hennepin County Attorney's Office, the county sheriff, FBI, ATF, and so on. And it was a lot around the clock, and I was definitely on edge every time my phone went off, because I know we literally cannot be everywhere. And until we have that person in custody, who knows what else could happen. And so while we do everything that we can to work on the investigation, to harden targets, to get out with community and tell folks what they can do to make their own facilities more secure, to enhance visibility and presence, and to be, you know, on this person's tail as much as possible, which really just, you know, hours and hours of video had been reviewed, you know, tracking this person all around in the city, outside the city. It is incredible work, but none of it ensures that this person can't do anything else until they are locked up behind bars.
I was getting updates multiple times a day from our chief, and the reason was we were all concerned. We were concerned about something like this happen again. It had already happened multiple times, and we've seen incidents from around the country where mosques or synagogues, places of worship, or people of color generally have been targeted. Obviously, in the past, they have been targeted around hate. We didn't know this particular circumstance that led to these particular attacks, but what we did know is that we had to get the particular individual off the street. And so the concern and the multiple calls that I was getting a day to get briefed in on the topic was because we did not want something like this to happen again while we were all working collectively to arrest the offender.
Yeah.
And I'll also say, you know, this is a big part of also building trust in our police officers. Yep. When people call for help, we want to make sure that there is a aggressive response. And by aggressive, I don't mean use of force. What I mean is we've got a whole lot of people that are working to investigate a particular matter and make sure that justice is done.
Yeah. Just to add on that, you know, the mayor and I have a different role than all the other law enforcement partners involved. We are here and we are present, you know, on the street with community. So while we are worried about trying to keep our residents, the people who visit our city, safe, I can't thank enough U.S. Attorney Andy Luger and all the federal and all of our partners involved, and even the Blue Earth County Sheriff's Office, because nobody's going to point the finger at them if something else happened in Minneapolis. It's our responsibility, and all of the law enforcement partners involved were incredibly dedicated to ensuring that we were able to swiftly bring this person to justice. So I cannot thank them enough for that.
Sorry, Mr. Mayor, you guys prayed up went to Moss last Friday. Obviously, you know, it's just thousands of people that come from all around Minnesota to pray together. In terms of, you know, security protocols, is there any, like,
So we've been working with CARE Minnesota, Jelani Hussein. He's provided us with a list of all of the masjids, and we're working with, actually we have members of the council who have volunteered to help us, and we're going out, we've already started going out to all the various masjids throughout the city. There's 20 in the city of Minneapolis, with our civilian crime prevention specialists to help review security features at facilities, which is something that's commonly done for businesses throughout the city, for other houses of worship. But what is particularly helpful when we have imams that are with us, when we have CARE Minnesota that is with us, is because sometimes through whatever barriers exist or whatever previous experiences people have had with law enforcement, they are resistant to allow us to come in, or maybe for some other reason, like they feel like, no, it's okay, we don't want to do this. So thanks to the imams, thanks to CARE, thanks to our community partners, members of the council, I think we are getting into more spaces and people are willing to listen to our suggestions to ensure that they have appropriate coverage with surveillance video. The cameras are facing the right way. They're taking other security measures around the building, because those types of things can definitely help keep people safe. And it's only through those partnerships with community and through religious leaders that they're actually allowing us to get into more places than we had been in the past.
Thanks, everybody.
Thank you.